गुड मॉर्निंग टू एवरी वन। इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट स्ट्रक्चर्स, इंक्लूड स्ट्रक्चर एंड अपेंड स्ट्रक्चर एंड एनहांसमेंट कैटेगरी। ओके, एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट सम इंटरनल टेबल्स कॉन्सेप्ट। Here I am taking on package. Yesterday I have created on package, right? Jet.sjf. I am taking that one. Okay, and here I want to create one more transaction here. This is a old one. Okay, this is the old one, but I don't want this transaction. So I will go for new transaction, you know, new TR. Okay, this is for creation of internal table. Okay, automatically the TR number will come here. Okay, just we have to provide some description. Automatically the TR number will come generate. So if you see like this, so first of all we have to write. I mean, we have to give some comments like who is creating this report program. Okay, created by SJF. Created on 24/7/2020. Package. Which package we are saving here? Jet.sjf. This is the package name. And description. What is the use of this what is the use of this program? Okay, these all are, see, if you go to any company, then we have to maintain this all information. Okay, whenever you are creating a report from scratch onwards, okay, other time we have to maintain this information: who created, when it is created, what is the purpose, so what is the TR number at first time we have generated for this one. So what is the, see, this all information we have to maintain in the comments. Okay, now what is internal table here? See, if you want to save something data, then where we will go? We will go to EC11 transaction and we will create one custom table there, and we can insert the data. Okay, that is okay, fine. Okay, that is permanent data. Okay, once you enter the data in the table, you can the data will be permanently saved in that database table. Okay, fine. Now, my requirement is I want to pass something data in the program level also. Okay, I want to create one table. Okay, I want to create one table in program level. Okay, this is not permanent data, this is temporary data only. Whenever I open the program, at that time only the data will be here. Okay, for example, my requirement is I am storing the information for sales orders. Okay, if you purchase something from Flipkart or Amazon like that, then they have to maintain, okay, some sales order number, and when he is ordering, what is the customer number, what is the customer address. So these all information they will save in one table. In the same way, SAP also we will save the sales information in one table. Okay, the table name is VVAK. Okay, standard table. SAP is providing this one. Okay, so SC11. I am going to SC11 transaction, and the table name is VVAK. Okay, VVAK is the header data. You already know about what is header data and item data. I discussed in the previous classes. Okay, VVAK table is the sales document header data. Okay, now I want to use this information. For example, 10 sales orders are there, 10 customers are there, they are ordering something. I want to fetch, okay, I want to fetch those customer information and I want to display in the report. I'm giving something information here. So this information, okay, this information I want to display in our program. Okay, so this is the table, that is okay. So if you want to pick the data, and we have to store in our program also, we have to keep the data in our table, in our program. How can we keep? Okay, this data I am taking from this table and I am passing into our program. Okay, and in our program, where we have to keep this one? Okay, that concept here, internal table. Okay, internal table. I will show you that one, and after that one will come here. Okay, how can we create the internal table? So before that one, we have to get to know about work area also. Just assume I am fetching the data and I am passing, like I'm creating one local table. Okay, the program I am creating one local table. Okay, so this is one table, this is an internal table. I am creating this one in our program. Okay, one more thing, work area is there. What is this work area? Okay, work area. Internal table and work area, two concepts are there. So internal table is nothing but one table only. Okay, internal table is nothing but one table only, but it is in program level. Okay, not in AC11 transaction, in the program level. Okay, it will save in this program only. Okay, the program name is ZSJF240720 is there, right? So in this program I am creating one table. If I click on back button, it won't contain anything. the table should not be there. Okay, you cannot open anywhere the table. The table will open in this program only. Okay, and if you want to fill something data, okay, if you want to fill something data in this internal table, then line by line. See, first of all, we have to fill here. First of all, I will take some customer information. Customer number 1, 2, 3, or 2, 3, 4. Customer name is Gayatri, and customer she is ordering the object, she is ordering one material on 10th. Okay, I am not giving full date here, just for your understanding purpose I am writing like this, and address is Bangalore. Okay, and 2, 3. See, first of all, I am filling one record. Okay, next I am coming to second record, third record, fourth record, like that, one by one. Okay, record mean we can fill only one record at a time. Record means total line. Okay, total line we can fill at a time. Okay, in the same way, second line, third line, fourth line. How we are filling the first line here? Okay, first of all, we have to fill this information. Okay, here. Here, 2, 3, 4. Next, Gayatri. Next, 10th is the date, and the Bangalore. Okay, I am filling the work area first of all, and after that one, we have to pass. We have to pass this data to internal table. Okay, it will fill first line. Okay, if you want to fill second line in the internal table, then what we have to do, we have to come to work area second time. Okay, 2, 3, 5 something name, and we have to pass this data to second line. Okay, line by line the internal table will fill here. Okay, first of all, we have to fill work area. From work area, I have to pass the data to internal table. Directly I cannot enter the data in the internal table. Okay, first of all, we have to fill work area, and after that one, internal table. It will go to internal table. Okay, here we have to use one syntax, append. Okay, append is the keyword here. Append work area to internal table. Okay, if you write like this. Okay, if we write like this, then what will happen? The record, whatever the record is there, that record will move to internal table. Okay, so let us see how can we declare and how can we use this one. So first of all, I will declare on work area. Okay, how can we declare data? I'm giving some chain operators. So in this work area, how many columns are there? Four columns are there. So I am using here chain operator, means I am using four variables here. Okay, mean four variables, it will come like one structure. Okay, it will come like one structure. Data, first one is the customer number. Type C. I'm giving here like this, type C. Okay, customer number. 1 minute. I will tell you why I am writing like this. I will tell you. Customer name of the tea type C. Document date type. Address. Address of party type C. In why I am writing like this? Okay. So if you want to declare any variable, then how you will declare data? Okay. A or data. Customer number. Okay. Of 10. Right, C. Okay, you will declare individual variable like this, right? So customer number, I mean customer name like this. If you want to declare individual, we can declare like this. But now what I'm doing, I am creating one work area. Work area is nothing but like one structure. Okay, structure means, so in SE11 also you have created one structure. What is the meaning of the structure in SE11? So we are adding some fields in the structure, and we can apply that structure in table level. Okay, so how many fields are available in that structure? All the fields are applying in a table. Okay, the same way here also. Okay, I am creating one structure. Structure means, I am binding some variables here. Okay, in the work area, how many columns are there? Four columns are there. With these four columns, okay, with these four columns, I am binding like one structure. Okay, so if you want to declare any structure in this program level, then we have to like this. Data. Okay, begin now. I'm giving work area name here. Okay, here WA indicates the work area. Okay, a few companies will follow like this. Okay, work area. Okay, or a few companies will follow like LS. Okay, if you want to declare any work area, then they may give the WA or LS. Okay, that will depend on company naming standards. Okay, a few companies will allow LS, a few companies will allow WA, a few companies it will like you can use anything. Okay, that will depend on company. Here I am taking WA. Okay, WA C underscore ST customer information. Okay, and here I am giving comma. I am not giving here full stop. Full stop means that line is ending here, but the line is not ended here. Okay. The structure is not completed yet. Okay, after that one, here chain operator I'm using. So not required to provide data once again here. Okay, and customer number of 10 type C. You already know about these all things. How can we declare the variables here? Okay, and end of work area customer. Okay, I am beginning the work area here. I'm beginning the structure here. So where the structure is ending. Okay, here I am passing end of work area customer. Okay, so in this we can declare work area. This is our work area here. Okay, now I want to declare one internal table also. Okay, I want to declare one internal table also. How can we declare data? So declaration part means data is the keyword, right? So now data IT customer like table of work area customer. Here IT means internal table. Okay, a few companies will follow LT also, local table. Okay, a few companies will follow LT, and a few companies will follow IT, and a few companies will tell you can use anything.
Hello,
this is
sir.
Yes.
Yeah, instead of like table of by using a type table of, is there any difference?
I will discuss after that. See, first of all,
okay,
I have to come one by one.
Okay,
here IT customer I'm taking IT underscore CEST. So is it fixed here? No, it's not fixed here. Okay, here also the naming is fixed here. No, it's not fixed here. You can take your name also. Okay, instead of WACUST, SJF. Okay, I can take SJF. Okay, so it is okay. So it is understanding to you. That is okay. After 2 years, you will leave the company, and one more member will come in your place. At that time, he will see this one. Okay, so begin of SJF and directly they will use SJF only. Okay, at that time he can't understand what is this SJF. Okay, once again he has to come to declaration part and he has to check each and every line here. Okay, so if you pass your names, your names at that time, the other guys, the other ABAPers cannot understand that naming conventions. So SAP or the companies, okay, software companies, they will follow some naming standards. Okay, if you follow like this, WACU underscore, WorkCareJCUST, then by seeing of that name, the ABAPer can easily understand, oh, this is one work area. Okay, we can fill one record in this work area. Okay, by seeing of that name, he can easily understand. Okay, fine. Now, what I am doing here? Not required. See here, for work area, I am declaring like this, right? Data, begin of and work area name and end of work area. So this is like one structure now. Okay, this is like one structure. By using this structure name, I am declaring one internal table. Okay, not required like one. See, this is a work area. In the same way, we can declare a internal table also. Not required to do like that. Okay, so if we declare one work area, this is on structure now. Okay, some fields are available in this structure now. Okay, by using the structure name, I can declare one internal table. Okay, automatically, how many columns are available in this structure, all the columns will come into internal table also. Okay, now I will fill the data. Okay, so what I have to fill the data? Work area, I have to fill the data. Okay, and after that one, I will pass the data to internal table, okay, line by line. So work area name is work area CUST. This is the work area, right? So in this work area, so which field we are filling now? Okay, first one is the customer number, right? So I will take a hyphen. Okay, hyphen I am taking here, and customer name. Okay, here two parts are coming. WA underscore CUST hyphen is coming. Hyphen is dividing the table name hyphen field name, or the structure name hyphen field name. Okay, so hyphen before that one is the structure name or work area name. Okay, after hyphen, this is the field name. Okay, you can ask this one also. This is the underscore. Underscore is different and hyphen is different. Okay, why we are using underscore instead of space? Instead of space, I am using underscore. That's it. Okay. Customer name equal to. Okay, Gayatri. Next, work area, customer. Okay, this is the work area now. Okay, work area WACUST. This is the work area name. Work area name hyphen. Next one is the. Customer number I am taking 1234. Okay, and work area CUST hyphen date equal to 24 or 20 07 2020. Okay, and work area customer address. Okay, I am filling the four columns here. Okay, in the work area, four columns are there. Work area hyphen field name. Work area hyphen field name I am taking, and I am filling the data here. Okay, now my requirement is I have to pass these four columns information into internal table. Okay, so I have filled this one now. I am moving the data from work area to internal table. Okay, how can we move? Through append statement here. Okay, append work area to internal table. Okay, if you write this syntax, automatically the data will move to internal table. Let us see how it will happen. Okay, we will check in debugging. You don't worry about it. How the internal table is creating, how the structure is there, how the data is moving, we will discuss each and everything in debugging level. Okay, now append work area customer to IT customer. Okay, one record is moved now. Now I will try to move second record. I will copy and paste here. I will copy and I will paste. Okay, and here I am passing the name as okay, and the number is I am changing something number here. Hyderabad. Okay, and third record also I am passing here. Okay, fine. Okay, fine. Now I want to execute in debugging level. Okay, I want to execute in debugging level. Save this one and check this one. Is there any problem? Okay, something is there. Work area customer does not have component field date. Okay, fine. So in this, see, document date is there. Okay, DOC date is there, but I have taken here only date. Okay, that is why it is showing something error. Okay, I will copy this one. See, I want to select the document date at a time. Then what we have to do, we have to select like this, right? So instead of that one, you just click on control button. Okay, you just click on control button and just click on document date at any place. Okay, automatically the total field, the total field name will select at a time. Okay, control C. And here also date is there. Instead of date, I have to pass document date, right? So I want to select this date now. Okay, so I am clicking on control button and I am clicking on that date. Okay, at any place. Okay, you just click on, I mean, you can click on left button in your mouse, click on left button. Okay, at that time automatically all the field will select. Now control V. Okay, total it will replace here. Okay, the same way here also date is there, but document date, and here also document date I have to pass. Now save the program, check the program. Okay, there is no syntax errors. Activate the program. Okay, how can we execute the program in the debugging level? Anyone have idea? How can we execute the program in debugging level? Anyone? Sorry.
Can you put on breakpoint, sir?
Point or the which slash?
Slash.
Word slash.
Slash H is okay, but there is no input screen. Okay. If you have any input screen, then only we will go for slash H. Okay. But I don't have any input screen here. That's why we have to go to breakpoints.
Statement.
Okay, so here now I want to keep the breakpoint at this 21 line. Why I have to keep the breakpoint at 21 line only? I can keep on 19th or 12, 13 like that also. See here, this is the declaration part. Declaration part means we are telling to the system, I am declaring something variable here. It will contain this type of data type and this type, this much of length. Like that, I'm telling to the system, that's it. Declaration means it won't contain anything. It won't contain any values in the declaration part. So we cannot keep any breakpoint at declaration part. Okay, we can keep the breakpoint at executable line. Executable line means it will contain something data or it is doing something calculation. Okay, so that type of lines are executable lines here. Here I am passing mean this field will contain something name here, right? So this is one executable line. So I am keeping one breakpoint here. So here two types of breakpoints are coming. Okay, this is the session breakpoint and this is the external breakpoint. Okay, so I will discuss about this external breakpoint in the concept of interfaces. Okay, so at that time you can understand very easily of this one. Okay, I am clicking on the breakpoint of this one, session breakpoint, or double click here, the 21 line number is coming here, right? So something space is coming, so just double click on that line. Okay, automatically session breakpoint will come. Okay, now execute the program. So it will come to the debugging mode. Now I am clicking on desktop 3. Why I am clicking on desktop 3 only, I will discuss it later. Desktop 1, 2 and standard structure tables, a lot of tabs are there. Okay, why I am clicking on desktop 3 only, I will discuss it later. First of all, work area, right? Work area CST is there, right? Just double click on that one. Okay, work areas customer is coming here. Next, internal table is there. Just double click on that internal table name also. Internal table name is also coming. Okay. Sorry. Here work area customer. Double click on this work area customer first of all. See how it is coming. Customer number, customer name, document date and address. Okay. See here I am not passing anything value in document date. That is why zero zeros are coming. Okay. So data type is D here. D means date. Okay. If you don't pass any date, automatically the 8 letters will be zeros only here. Okay. Date DD MM YY YY. Okay. Like that, the date will come here, right? So all the things will be 000 like that. 8 zeros will come. Default value for date is 8 zeros. Okay. And internal table also is there. Okay. IT CES. Double click on this one. See, it is coming like one table here. Okay. It is forming like one table. Okay, in this one, customer number, customer name, document date and address. We can see the data type and length also in the brackets. Okay, first one is the row number. Okay, it will come by default, not required to pass this one. Okay, not required to declare this one. Automatically it will come in the debugging level. Okay, so first row, second row, third row, like that, the row number it will indicate, that's it. Okay, and here you can see internal table IT customer is there. Here 0 into 4 is there. Okay, 0 into 4. What is the meaning of this 0 into 4? 0 means records. How many records are available in this internal table? 0 records are available. And 4 means columns. How many columns are there? 4 columns are there in this internal table. Okay, customer number, name, document date, address. 4 columns are available. Okay, that is the meaning of 0 into 4. And 176 is the size of that one, that is not required here. Just we have to check this one only, 0 into 4. Now the cursor is a 21 line. Okay, the cursor is a 21 line. Now this is a work area, right? Now what I will do, each and every field I will double click. Okay, document date and address. Okay, work area hyphen field name. Okay, work area hyphen field name. I am double clicking on four columns, four fields. I am double clicking. Okay. Now the cursor is at 21 line. Okay. Now the cursor is at 21 line. Just click on F5 button. F5 is for one line execution. Okay. One line execution. Click on F5 button. See, automatically here Gayatri is coming. The customer name Gayatri name is coming. Okay. You will double. 1 minute, guys. sorry for the disturbance. See, work area customer, I mean, work area hyphen field name is filling here Gayatri, because the 21 lane is executed. Whatever the name is there, that name is updating here. And if you double click on this work area, customer work area, automatically Gayatri name is also coming here. Okay. Now, click on F5 button. F5. Here, customer number. Customer number is coming like 1234. Okay. And if you double click, 1234. Work area hyphen field name. I am double clicking. Okay. Next one. Document date is coming here. Click on F5 button. See here. 20.7.20 is coming here. Okay. Why it is coming like that? Okay. Why it's coming like that? If you check here in the work area customer, here also it will come like that only. 20.7.20. Okay, this is different one. I will tell you why it is coming like that. I will tell you later. Okay, after execution of this program, I will tell you. We have to give in different format. Okay, date is coming, right? So it will allow some. See, the class will disconnect in 1 minute. So you can reconnect the class once again. Okay. We have to give the date format in a different way. Okay, now. Here, Bangalore also coming. Okay, Bangalore also.